HIV treatment, opportunistic infection in HIV/AIDS. Hello folks, it's Mark Medicals here teaching you about HIV infection like HIV symptoms, HIV testing, and HIV transmission. Question, what common illnesses affect people living with HIV? Alright, in this video, you learn about the following. 1. HIV opportunistic infection definition. 2. What is the most common opportunistic infection in HIV/AIDS? 3. Prevention of opportunistic infection in HIV/AIDS. 4. Treatment of opportunistic infection in HIV. Alright, with no further ado, here are all the answers. 1. HIV opportunistic infection definition. Any opportunistic infection is any infection from a germ that does not usually cause disease. Opportunistic infections take advantage of your weakened immunity. For instance, ladies who are pregnant have higher chances of getting vaginal candidiasis just because pregnancy affects their body immunity. People with diabetes are prone to fungal infections and cancers due to diabetes' effects on immunity. Children and the elderly suffer from non-common illnesses just because their immunity is not so strong. And finally, people living with untreated HIV are prone to illnesses that are not common in HIV-negative people. So if your natural body immunity is weakened by any condition, not HIV alone, prepare for being attacked by many rare infections. 2. What is the most common opportunistic infection in HIV? You will most likely not see any opportunistic infections if your CD4 cell counts are above 500. But if they fall below, then prepare to meet infections caused by herpes simplex virus that cause sores on your lips and mouth, salmonella infection which affects your stomach and intestines, candidiasis or thrush, fungal infection of the mouth, bronchi, trachea, lungs, esophagus, or vagina, and toxoplasmosis, a parasitic infection that can affect the brain. These are the common early opportunistic infections seen in most clinics. But, if your CD4 cells continue to fall to below 200, you will have much more health problems which are very serious. We shall say you are an AIDS patient once your CD4 cell counts fall to below 50, and here, you will have more serious infections like persistent diarrhea or wasting syndrome, unexplained persistent fevers, in and out of the hospital, cancers, TB, and so many illnesses. 3. Prevention of opportunistic infection in HIV. The good news is that all those dreadful infections mentioned are preventable and treatable. But as always, prevention is always better than cure, right? The only way to prevent or stop those infections from happening is by early HIV testing, diagnosis, and very early HIV treatment. HIV medications eliminate HIV from your blood to undetectable levels and therefore restore your body's natural immunity. Starting medicines when it is late may not restore your immunity back to its original functioning capacity, a reason we want all of us to go for routine testing and if infected start medications immediately. 4. Treatment of opportunistic infection in HIV. It is true, we can treat your opportunistic infections, but the costs of treatment will always be high, and also the going through the tests and medications are no good experience. For instance, TB treatments could last from 6 or 12 months or beyond, Kaposi sarcoma treatment could be a lifetime, and other diseases like toxoplasmosis, CMA could damage your body parts for good. I did not mean to scare you guys, but in my medical experience, I have seen patients go through the hell of life just because they delayed HIV testing and therefore started HIV treatment when it was too late. I want to end by telling you not to worry since we have the best HIV treatment today. Actually, the life expectancy of people living with HIV is the same as the HIV negative as long as you are on your medications. Those mentioned illnesses are rarely seen today just because of good medical care services available today.